Привет! Today we're gonna take a very important compound of any language, verbs. In Russian, verbs in the present tense divided into two groups, first and second. Sometimes in grammar books they call it first and second conjugations, and irregular. So first and second group, they end in a little bit different, I will show you. And the regular group is they just don't want to be like everybody else, don't want to follow the rules, they completely different and need to be memorized. I'll show you this as well. Okay, let's start. Verbs, something that we do, action. In Russian language, verbs in present tense divided in two groups, first group, second group. Okay, let's take a verb from the first group first. Znать, which means to know. So this is a dictionary form, basic form. You can't just use it like this, like I to know, we to know, clumsy way of saying this. So what you do in English, you take away to, and then you say I know, we know, they know. The only time you change it when you say he, she, or it, you put s on the end. So this is the only time you change your verb. He knows. So I'll show you how we change it in Russian. Okay, знать. We already established that this is a basic form to know. Let's take a pronouns first. Let's take first person. First person is I in English and я. In Russian, we, okay. Second person is you. In Russian is ты. In Russian we have two you. Ты for friends and family, and we, it's a polite version, or when you address to an audience, you say вы. And also, it's in everyday conversation when you go to shop, hospitals, when you talk somebody you don't know. So it's a polite way of saying you. Okay. Group is he, she, and it. Он, она, оно. Okay. And plural, they. Gonna be они. Do you see it? Yeah. So он, he, она, she, оно, it, они, they. Okay, which is actually have a sense, because if you watch the previous lesson with the gender, you know that N is consonant responsible for masculine gender, A feminine gender, or neutral, and E plural. So this is how you can remember those as well. Okay, we have all these pronouns here, and let's change the verb. We're gonna take away ти, the last two letters here. What left is a steam. We're gonna use this steam for everybody, which is a easy part. I'm not gonna write it down every time because we're gonna use it for everybody. So this team for я, мы, ты, вы, etc. The only thing that's gonna change here is endings. So if you wanna say I know, я знаю, я знаю. We know, change ending gonna be ем, мы знаем. You know, ты знаешь. This is the ending for ты. You polite ете, он ет, она. The same ет, оно ет. And они, ending gonna be ют. Okay, so let's try to say it. I know, я знаю, we know, мы знаем, you know, ты знаешь, you polite, вы знаете, он знает, она знает, оно знает, они знают. Okay, and in English it's gonna be I know, we know, you know, and here he knows us on the end, and in Russian it's yet. Okay, so now when we know the ending here, we actually don't really need those, because these people, they're here in the ending. Sometimes in Russian language you will find that we not always say pronoun with verbs. It's very usual and it's very normal in Russian to omit pronouns. Some people never use them. You can say знаю, which means I know, which already give you the hint that who knows, or you say не знаю, don't know, I don't know. Mm-hmm. Or you can say знают, they know, but in Russian, okay, in Russian it's like, it's not really there, but it's all, but it's there. You say знают, so this ending give you the information that they know. Yeah, in English you can't do that. In Russian you can. So you can use it pronoun and ending. You can use it without pronoun. If you're confident with endings, it's self-explanatory. Okay, so let's take another one. Let's take another verb, for example. Работать, to work. You, it's for я, ем is мы, okay, ешь is you, ты, ете вы, mm-hmm. Ет он, она, оно, and ют они, okay. Restore the pronoun from the endings. Okay, what we're gonna do? We're gonna take away this ending here. What left is a steam, работа. This steam will work with everybody. So just make it easy, just to put it once. Работа. Ta-da. Okay. So, я работаю, мы работаем, ты работаешь, вы работаете, он работает, она работает, оно работает. In English, S on the end. And they, они работают. Good? Okay, let's try another one. Let's take делать. Делать, it's to do or to make. So to change it, you need to take away the ending, take the steam out, put the steam here, дела, and then put endings on top. I'm doing, я делаю, мы делаем, ты делаешь, вы делаете, он делает, она делает, оно делает, они делают. Okay? All right. If you want to ask question, what do you do? What are you doing? You say, что? What? Ты делаешь? It's easy. It's easy to ask question in Russian. You don't need any auxiliary verbs like do, are you. You don't need those in Russian. All you need to do, just put the question mark in the end, make curiosity on your face, or intonation, of course, so people know that you're asking the question, because there is no other way to know this. And yeah, and this is a question. Что делаешь? What are you doing? Mm-hmm. Let's take this one. Гулять. Гулять is to walk. This is the first meaning. And then we have another meaning. To have fun. To go out. And, you know, get loose. To go out to have fun. Okay. Take away tea. What is left is what we need. Steam. Гулять. Works with everybody, and the ending я гуляю, мы гуляем, ты гуляешь, вы гуляете, он гуляет, она гуляет, оно гуляет, они гуляют. Okay? Okay, let's take this verb to wait, ждать, ждать. Okay, I do know we're gonna take away this ending here. What is left is our steam. Ждать. Ж. Д. Okay, I want you to pronounce this steam with this ending. Ждю. You almost twist your tongue when you do this. Something not right. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna substitute this letter U with more open one, U. They kind of the same, and we sometimes can use either of those. Okay, so now try to say this team with this letter. Жду. How easy is that? Easy. Жду. Okay, so now we know that after certain letters, it will be easier to pronounce U rather than U. Okay? Then, ждем, ждешь. Saying this, feel effort. Okay, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put dots here. Your. Ждем, ждешь, ждете, ждет. Much easier and grammatically correct as well. What a coincidence. Я жду, I'm waiting. Мы ждем, we're waiting. Ты ждешь, you. Вы ждете, you polite. Он, она, оно ждет. He, she, it waits. Они ждут. And here, instead of you, you put U, of course, ждут. Just logical. Ждут. Rather than ждют. Ждут. So now we know that verbs in the first group can carry these endings. Not only year, but sometimes your. So we won't twist our tongue. Okay, let's take this verb here, брать, to take. By the way, without this letter here, брат means brother, a noun, and брать is to take. Okay, how are we gonna change this? Well, we're supposed to take away this ending and put steam, and then put endings on top. Easy. But with this verb, and I'll give you the list of other verbs, you need to change steam. You can't use this steam brr. No. Well, you can if you want, but I don't think you will sound human, because it just, it will be weird sound if you do, if you will do this. And so for this reason, somebody before us, I think our ancestors, and now it's in the grammar book, they changed stem, so we will sound more natural. So what basically they did, they just put letter here. So they made a platform to put endings on top. What we get now? All right, here. What do you think? This ending or this ending? Biru or biru? First one, isn't it? First one sounds more natural. Okay. So, I take, я беру. We take, мы. And here, we're gonna put your on top. Берем rather than берем. Берем. Ты берешь, you take. Вы берете, you polite take. Он, она, оно, he, she, it takes, берет. They take, они берут. And here as well, this sounds more natural, берут, rather than берут. So it's gonna be this ending. If you want to make negative sentence, it's very easy. Don't or doesn't, just put не. Okay. Я не беру, I don't take. Мы не берем, we don't take. They, они не берут, they don't take, etc. So, не, it's negative. Don't or doesn't. Mm-hmm. Easy. These verbs, they seem gonna be different. So you need to know that. Once you know this team, you put endings on top. That's it, easy. To take, брать, steam gonna be бер. To give, давать, steam is да. To write, писать, steam is пиш. To call, звать, steam зов. To sing, петь, steam is по. So if you wanna say I'm singing, you say я пою. Ты поешь, they поют, etc. Поют. To drink, пить. I'm drinking, я пью. I don't drink, я не пью. Mm-hmm. And let's take this one. To hit, бить. Beach. To hit. Steam gonna be a little different as well. B. This is the steam. So if I'm hitting something or somebody, я бью. I don't hit. Я не бью. You hit. Бьёшь. These verbs here, they seem a little bit different. So this is a list. Yeah. And then you put endings on top. Easy. Okay, let's take second conjugation, second group. Most of the verbs from second group ending on each. Most of them, not all. For example, this verb here, верить. Okay. Which means to believe. We're going to take away three letters from here. And what is left? There is a steam here, вер. Вер. Mm-hmm. Before I give you the ending for the second group, let's pretend that there is no other endings in existence of Russian language, only this. try to pronounce those ending with this stem. Верю, it's okay, but верим, веришь, like it's you making an effort to say yeah sound after this. You just make it harder for you to pronounce this. So I think what our ancestors came up with, they just replaced this letter with easier one to pronounce. We're gonna just substitute yeah with E. That's all. E. 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 Can I just put one ending here? Because we already know that it's one for all three, so I just make it easy of it. Okay? And this stays the same. Okay, now then look what happened. Верим, веришь, верите, верит. It's plain, it's steady, it flows. It's easier. Much, you don't make much effort, if any. So this is the difference between first group and second group, just with this letter. Okay? So я верю, I believe, мы верим, ты веришь, вы верите, он верит, она верит, оно верит, они. And again, this one is gonna be different ending, верят. So sometimes it's ят and sometimes it's ют. Why? The same reason here, because я letter is easier to say after this letter. Try yourself and see how your tongue react. Your tongue will be grateful for you if you use this letter instead of this. If you say они верят, easy. If you say они верят, it's you make an effort. Let's take another one. Говорить. Grammatically correct will be to say говорить. But when it's two O in between the consonant, we're prone to say а. Говорить. People prone to do stuff that easier, that's all. Second group. Take away this. What is left is a stem, and we're gonna put it here in front of our endings. Говор. This is the first group, so what we're going to do with the second group, we just substitute with E, because it's easier to say. Говоришь. And it's also grammatically correct. Говорите. Not just because it's easier to say. Okay. So I talk, я говорю. Мы говорим. You talk, ты говоришь. Вы говорите. Он говорит, она говорит, оно говорит, они. In this case, it's gonna be ят. Говорят, о, говорят. You listen yourself. Говорят, говорят. First one, right? Говорят. Okay, let's take one more. Let's take любить. Любить, to love. Okay, take away this. This is the stem loop. Они любят. Она, she loves, любит. Он любит. Вы любите, you love, ты любишь. We love, мы любим, and я gonna be люб, and then we're gonna put extra letter here, л. So it's gonna sound like люблю. Why we put this letter here? What's the necessity of it? Look what's happened when I say я люблю. Doesn't sound right. This letter helps you to pronounce you. It's like a platform for you to say it more easily. That's why. So, I love gonna be я люблю. So, this letter came here to help us so it will be more easier to pronounce. Okay? Я люблю тебя. Kind of actually makes sense. Я люблю. All right. So now let's sum up. This is the first group. This is second group. Ending with the first group. You, or it can be у, ем, еш, ете, ет, ют. So this is our ending here. Еш, ете, ет, ют. Okay? And second group endings. You, им, иш, ите, ит, ят. And sometimes can be ут, right? Ут. Ут. У. All right. This is our second group endings. Okay. So we can actually erase the verb. We can use any verb or from the second group with this one. And the same, we can erase this I know verb. This is our endings. So now you can see that the main difference between first and second group is just one letter, E. Not Е, but E. So when you don't have your grammar book or your dictionary with you, you're thinking, oh, which group is this, first or second? First conjugation or second conjugation? Oh my God. And, well, you don't actually need maybe go to the grammar book. Just follow your instincts, your tone, like try to say the same verb, let's say with this ending and with this ending. And you will see which one is more freely, which one is more natural to say, and probably this is gonna be the right answer because our body reacts right. So without even knowing the grammar points, your tongue will already say which one sounds easier, which one sounds more natural. Okay, like if you wanna say you believe, веришь. Look, веришь, how easy to say, and we'll say веришь, up. No, it's not easy at all. This belongs to this one. We also have another group, which is irregular verbs. They don't want to follow the rules. They want to be specials. They don't really fit into first or second group. Sometimes they have features from both groups and they need to be memorized. Okay, let's take a look. For example, хотеть, to want. And look how it changes. It's not only have features from the second group and first group ending, its theme also changes. Like when you say I want, я хочу, it has че. And if we say we want, мы хотим, it has те here. So this theme also is different. Look at that. Ay, ay, ay. Well, all you can do here is just to memorize this verb. Okay, let's take this verb moч, which means can. It belongs to the first group because the ending is here, everywhere. So it's okay with this. But the theme is different. Like I can, я могу, г. And if you say we can, мы можем. The theme is different again. Ты можешь, you can, вы можете, you plural can, он, она, оно может. And here again, they can. We have a difference in here, могут. So it should be memorized as well. Let's take another irregular verb. Есть, to eat. Yeah, we use this every day, so it's better for us if we memorize this. Я ем. So look how it changes. Я ем. Мы едим. We eat. Ты ешь. You eat. Вы едите. You polite. Он, она, оно. He, she, it. Ест. Они едят. So there is no rules apply and should be memorized. Yeah. Okay, let's take a look how do we make questions in Russian. It's extremely complicated. All you need to do, put question mark. That's it. Here, in English, you work, this is statement, and do you work is a question. So you need to add auxiliary verb here to make a question. In Russian, we don't have this. Ты работаешь statement, ты работаешь question. This is a statement, this is a question. What the difference? Difference is question mark. This is on the paper. You probably will ask, what about the verbal when you're saying things? How people know that you're asking a question? Because you're not gonna have a sign with a question mark. Well, you need to have a question mark on your face or in your intonation, so people know that you're asking a question. For example, you work, statement. Ты работаешь. I'm asking a question now. Ты работаешь? Ты работаешь? Intonation. Okay, you can also ask more substantial questions like, where do you work? Где ты работаешь? When? Когда? When do you work? Когда ты работаешь? So in other words, how do you work? Как? Как ты работаешь? Why do you work? Почему or зачем? It's the same meaning. Why? Почему? Зачем? Why do you work? So you put question words on top. You can also use those. Mm-hmm. Easy. Okay, let's see how we change the verb when we draw an attention, like action verb. Take a look. Give me. Listen to me. When we're asking people action verbs, the verbs that we use to emphasize action, as a commands, orders, it has this emotional and energetic charge to it. Okay, to do, делать. Look what's happened here. If we take away this, do. Делай. This is how it works. In English, you just take away two, put exclamation mark, do. Alright? And this is enough to draw attention. In Russian, you take away ending and put е on top. Делай. Do. Okay? Hey, you, listen. Слушай. Mm-hmm. Work. Работай. Easy. Shoot. Стреляй. To go. Instead of year, we're gonna put E, because it's almost impossible to produce this sound after that. So that's why it's sister letter, E, E, D, go. Mm-hmm. Here, We're not gonna put anything on top because e letter already exists in, within this team, and it's enough. Люби. Люби, love. Mm-hmm. Love. Go. And speak up, speak. You would say говори. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, what happens with the verbs when you tell people what to do? They it look like they losing their endings as they scared, and then there is this letters on top. Делай, знай, работай, гуляй, shoot, стреляй, give me, давай, люби, speak, говори, look, смотри, listen, слушай. Mm-hmm. You can hear that they have this energy charge somehow with this делай, знай, давай, I, up, like motivation underneath these words, you know, делай, do, стреляй, up, I. Okay, once again, no, знай, give, давай, work, работай, watch, смотри, listen, слушай, do, делай. Okay, you can say this to your friend again, and if you say this, let's say at work or you want to be polite, you just need to put tia on the end. It's like equivalent of please. Please know, please work, please watch, please take a look, please do. So this tia on the end, it's a polite form of giving orders, of asking people language. When you say please, пожалуйста, делайте, it's kind of means please do, please, you know, it's like in this joke, I don't repeat twice. So it's, you know. But it's not gonna hurt. Some people still say пожалуйста and tear on them, so you're welcome, super polite. But if you're in a hurry, you can omit пожалуйста and you still have tear on the end, you still being polite. But to say пожалуйста and tear, it gives you a credit. It's better to say both. Mm-hmm. And when you with friends, you don't need to say tia, you just say hey, you give it to me, давай. Okay, and let's take some exceptions. Let's take, like, for example, брать, it's to take. And if you want to say take, you will say бери. You will change the stem because some of the verbs, their stem is changing. So that's why it looks a little bit different. So in this case, it's going to be бери, take. And for example, быть, this verb means to be. And if you want to say be a man, be a woman, you will see будь. Strange, isn't it? But yeah, this is how we use it. Beat, to hit, gonna change its theme, bay, hit. And beat, to drink, gonna change its theme as well, pay. Have a drink. Okay, and if you wanna sound polite, put here on top, будьте, be, бейте, please hit, пейте, please drink. Okay, it just, please hit. You hit somebody and you still remain polite. Okay, let's take a look at the basic form words again from the dictionary infinitives. So, they're sitting in the dictionary, like doing nothing. We can't use them at all like this. We always need to change them. No, they can be helpful. They can be useful. We can use them with some words. I'll give you six, let's call it super six words. Then you can use them without changing anything. Sounds good. With these words that I will give you, you can take any verb from the dictionary and use it without changing it. Я хочу, I want, like in English, I want to go, I want to love, I want to watch. You actually use exactly the same basic form infinitive, right? So, я хочу делать, я хочу знать, I want to know, I want to shoot, я хочу стрелять, etc. Another one, я люблю. So when you already change one verb, you don't need to change another one. Another one just going in its basic form. Okay, я люблю, I love to work, я люблю работать, I love to watch movies, я люблю смотреть фильмы. Okay, я буду. Я буду means I will be. So this is one of the future forms. Я буду гулять, I will be going out. Я буду спать, I will be sleeping. Я буду идти, I will be going. Я буду знать, I will be knowing, I will know. Я буду стрелять, I will be shooting. You can use this one. Then you can use мне надо, I need. Мне надо знать, I need to know. Мне надо гулять, I need to go out. Мне надо спать, I need to sleep. Mm-hmm. So, what else? Мне нравится. Мне нравится. Means I like. Мне нравится знать. I like to know. Мне нравится работать. I like to work. Мне нравится спать. I like to sleep. Okay? And let's take this one. Давай. Давай. Давай means let's. Let us. Let's. One of the meaning of давай is let's. Let's shoot. Давай стрелять. Let's work. Давай работать. Let's watch movie. Давай смотреть фильм. Let's go out. Давай гулять. Let's sleep. Давай спать. And давай. Okay, so with this, now that we're in the learning process and we want to start talk as soon as possible, so this is very easy way to start talking right now. You take these ones, put infinitive on top, a verb from the dictionary, and you already have a sentence. You don't need invent bicycles, it's already invented. All you need to do, just use this formula. Я хочу, I want, я люблю, I love, я буду, I will be, мне надо, I need, мне нравится, I like, давай, let's. And also you can put не in front, which means don't. More naturally will be to put don't here. Я не хочу знать, I don't wanna know. I don't love to shoot, я не люблю стрелять. I'm not gonna be working, я не буду работать. I don't need to sleep, мне не надо спать. I don't need to go, мне не надо идти, etc. So don't or doesn't in Russian is не. Very simple. Put не in between and you will have a negative sentence. I don't. Huh? Okay, and we're gonna listen the song and pick it up these phrases. Я люблю тебя means I love you. Я люблю тебя. And this one, это здорово, that's awesome. Let's pick it up from the song.
Я люблю тебя, это здорово. Я люблю тебя, это здорово. Это здорово. Это здорово. Я люблю тебя, это здорово. Это здорово. Это здорово. Я люблю тебя. Я люблю тебя. Это здорово. Это здорово. Это здорово. Я люблю тебя.
Гитара семиструнная, чего сидеть догаривать, ведь ночь такая лунная.
А ну давай, давай наяривай, гитара семиструнная, чего сидеть догаривать, ведь ночь такая лунная.
А ну налей-лей, не жалей, похмелье штука тонкая. А ну давай-ка, Николай, играй, гитара звонкая.
А ну налей-лей, не жалей, похмелье штука тонкая.
А ну чего сидеть догаривать, ведь ночь такая лунная.
А ну давай, давай наяривай, гитара семиструнная, чего сидеть догаривать, ведь ночь такая лунная.
А ну налей-лей, не жалей, похмелье штука тонкая. А ну давай-ка, Николай, играй, гитара звонкая.
А ну налей-лей, не жалей, похмелье штука тонкая.
А ну давай, давай.
Thank you. наяривай.